Hey everyone, it's Daphne from Scrap and Create, and we're working on Charmed, Graphic 45's latest collection. And I haven't decided what page this is yet, so I'm not going to give you a page number at the moment. After I get done decorating it, I will, and it'll be clear in the title of the video. But we're going to do some flaps on both sides, and we're going to do some offsetting, so there's going to be some interesting measurements going on. But one of the first things that you're going to need to do is cut 4 3/4 by 8 inch, and you're going to have a left one and a right one. And I'm going to offset this because I want to keep, because this is an 8x10 album, I want to keep this area a little bit open next to the spine. So it's probably going to be page 2, so there's a hint. In fact, I'm pretty sure it's either going to be page 2 or page 4, and I haven't decided, but it's not page 1. So there's another thing. I'm going to be building this out of order, even though the last few albums that I've done in order. This one's definitely, the build is going to be not in the same sequence as the page. Okay, so the tricky thing about this page is we're going to have an offset here. So this is a 1-inch strip that's going to go right here. Then we're going to overlay one flap here, and then we're going to have a second flap here, and there's going to be a 1/2-inch gap between the two. So finding this middle point is just a little bit tricky. So here's what I did. So I came in, and it's a little hard to see because it's pencil, but I came in 1 inch. Let me put it on a 1-inch line. So I came in 1 inch from the right-hand side, and I put a tick mark. Then I found my center point between, since this is 10 inches, this is now 9 inches, and it's right here, and I just broke my lead. Okay, and then I moved it out 1/4 inch on each side because I know I want a 1/2 inch in here. So that's how I came up with this. Another way to do this is, so again, this is 8x10, is to come in 4 1/4 inches. There's your tick mark, and that's the where you're going to lay in your 1/2 inch line. And then if you go the other way, it's again 4 1/4 inches from your 1-inch mark. Okay, so that's what I did. So why does all that matter? Well, it matters because this is also going to help you line up where your flap goes. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to lay down this 1-inch piece of paper. Now keep in mind that this is 1 inch and I marked at 1 inch, so that means once I offset it slightly to have the border around it, it's actually going to go past your tick mark, and that's fine. That's what we want. We want the hinge of the flap to lay right on the tick mark, and you'll see what I mean in just a minute. And by doing that, it helps it helps the hinge mechanism work freely and not get hung up on the edge of this paper. I'm going to bring this up so that you can get a closer look at it. So you can see the tick mark is on the inside of the purple paper, okay? So that tick mark is actually where we're going to lay, let me make sure this is 4 3/4, yeah. The edge is going to go right there. So you're going to go slightly over this purple, and that means there's not going to be any interference. If it was slightly in front of it, occasionally it gets stuck and you might get a buckle. So it's going to go slightly over. So now that we've got that in place, it's a little bit high, but I'm okay with that. Let's go ahead and put in our first flap. Again, this is 4 3/4 by 8 inches. You're going to score a 1/2 inch on the 4 3/4 inch side. You're going to line it up. I'm going to do one corner and then line up the other with your tick marks, which are 1 inch from the right-hand side of the pocket page. Okay, and our edges look beautiful. Okay, so you've got one flap. Now you can see, hopefully you can see, there's two tick marks here. There's the center line and then 1/4 inch on either side. That's where this Not this one, this one. This half inch strip is gonna go like so, okay? And it's hard to see, but I marked it on both sides. So it's gonna go like that. So the next thing is we have a, so I'm gonna set that aside for a moment, but you do need to have those marks there. So the next thing is the other 4 3/4. Remember, we cut two. It's gonna go flush with the left-hand edge of the pocket page. And that should line right up with your pencil mark for your purple half-inch strip. And it does. Okay, so now you've got these two. We're gonna have a purple strip in the middle. And it can actually be a little bit, let me think about that for a second. You know, I did a half inch, but let's do it wider. And I'm gonna tell you why. We're actually gonna put another flap on each side this way, okay? And so, same as over here, I want my flap to actually rest on the purple. So, I'm gonna take that back. This is another 1 inch strip. So I wanna put it in the center here, and then each one of these flaps is gonna lay on top of it. It doesn't really need to be a whole inch. 3/4 of an inch would work too, but this is already cut. Let me make sure it's the right. Yeah, it's already cut. I've already got it sitting here, so I'm gonna use it. Okay, so we've got our left and right flaps in, and what I've done is I've closed my flap and I put a pencil mark here. Wow, it doesn't show up very well. So that I know where to install the second flap. And I want to do it on both sides so it goes in straight. So I did it on the purple, but I had a hard time seeing it. So I'm going to line up the smaller of the two flaps is 4 5/8 by 8, 4 5/8 by 8. You're going to need two of those. And we're going to line it up with those new pencil marks that we just made. And then when we close this, so you're gonna have clearance over here by this hinge, but it's also going to be hidden underneath the top panel. So that's our goal. That's what the pencil marks are. You wanna make sure you're on the inside of that mark. Get it in straight? Yeah, that's pretty straight. Okay, so that's gonna close like so. And when I say straight, I wanna make sure I don't have any edges hanging off. That looks good. So the second one, same thing. We are looking to apply that right on our pencil marks here and here. And I think I'm good to go. Got my backing off. Just inside that pencil mark. And I'm laying it and pivoting it to bring it in line with the pocket page. Now the next thing I want to do is close this and yep, everything's nice and tidy. Perfect, okay? So there, we're making some progress. I'm gonna go ahead and burnish everything. Okay, now on the left-hand side, we are going to place a pocket. This pocket is 9 inches. Sorry. 9 inches by 3 1/4. 3 1/4 by 9. You're gonna score a half inch on three of those sides. We're gonna have a pocket right here. I don't don't know what she's barking at. I'll try to get some of that out of the background. She's turning into a grouchy old lady. All right. Same thing. I like to put one corner down and kind of pivot it to get it as lined up as possible with the flap or pocket page, whatever it's being placed on top of. Okay, so that's that. And then we're going to have a card that goes inside this pocket. Like it's not doing. There we go. Should go all the way down. There it goes. Like so. And this is 8x7. 8x7. And you're going to score at... That's going to be your card. Now, it's possible I may shorten this, but for right now, let's plan on it being that size. And I'm also planning on this becoming the decorative part of this flap. So I'm planning on having the outside of the flap or outside of the card be exposed, but I haven't figured out my magnets yet. Okay, now back over to this side. This side, we're also going to place a pocket, but this pocket is going to be vertical. So we've got a horizontal and a vertical. Let me double check my measurements, and I also need to add tape. So this is 5 1/4 by 6 1/2. And let me double check and make sure. Yes, that's right. So it's going to fit the width and then come down about 2 inches and we'll have the pocket. So let's add some tape. Had a couple people ask me about what I was tearing the tape with. This is what we call a tape tear tool. I created this little doodad out of necessity. I used to just use an acrylic block, but it was hard to pick up and hang on to, and also your fingers were interfering with keeping it flush on your work surface. So a friend of mine who has a Glowforge cut these out for us, and this is a little pop socket. So even when you travel or go to crafting events, you can flatten it for easy storage. I have two. I have a clear one, which was the first version. The second version is the green, which is my preference because it's easier to find on my desktop. And you can find those in our store. Just search for tape tear tool. Okay. Okay, so this pocket is going to be flush with the three lower edges. There we go. Okay. Easy peasy. This has an insert. The insert is 4 by 7 1/2. And I've cut my corners with the corner chomper. They call that the stub end. Okay, so we've got a pocket here and a pocket here. There's the card that goes into this pocket. Okay, now I'm going to take a break and think through how I'm layering my papers and decide how I'm going to keep everything nice and tidy and closed with magnets. So I'll be back shortly, and when I'm back, we'll also start decorating. Okay. I have a new idea. So I was originally going to leave the top flap out as the decoration for this side, and I was going to place this right here on the card. So what I've decided to do is go ahead and put the whole card in the pocket, and then this will be a decoration on top of this pocket, and it'll go slightly over. I need something to... You can see what I mean. And it'll go over the pocket and just be a decorative piece right here. So instead of placing it on the card, I'm going to place it on the pocket and the card will go behind everything. This is one of the ephemera cards, and it had a frame around it, and I cut that all away just so it would be narrower and serve this purpose. So that's what we're going to do, which means this is super simple to keep closed. We just put a magnet here and a magnet here. And that's why I want to wait for a few minutes to really think about how am I going to keep all this closed and keep the card flat. And here's what I came up with. So, my goodness, I don't know what her problem is, guys. So that's simple. And the same thing over here, because the insert goes in all the way. I don't have to worry about it flapping around and getting in the way of anything. So it's just a simple magnet on each side. Okay, that's going to keep these two things closed. And like I said, each one has either an insert or a card that's going to go in the pocket. And of course, these cards make for perfect places to put your photos inside. And then you don't have to worry about your photos chafing on anything. And then this will be the decoration that I wind up putting here. So I'm ready to break and organize my designer paper so that when we come back, we can decorate the rest of this page. All right, and I'm committing to a page number now. This is going to be page number two. Page number two. Okay, thanks everybody for tuning in. I'll be back shortly with the rest of this page number two. Hey everyone, it's Daphne. Okay, I've got some papers lined up so we can start decorating. I've done all the A side, and I'll have to take a quick break to double check trim and get the B sides ready, but I'm ready to go at least on the A side. So this is from the 12 by 12 collection pack, and it's going to go on this pocket here and this pocket here, so that's pretty easy to remember. Both pockets get covered with the pumpkin paper from the 12 by 12 collection. In fact, everything that you see so far is from 12 by 12 collection or the 12 by 12 patterns and solids. I haven't used any of the 8 by 8 yet. And in fact, I think, I say that, yeah, everything's from the 12 by 12. I don't think I've even used any of the patterns yet. All right, so that's lovely. So the pocket liner for both, the pocket liner is going to be this stripe paper, and it's already inked and ready to go. Pretty sure this is from the 12 by 12, just double checking. The pattern looked a little bit small on the other side, but it's from the 12 by 12. And I'm turning it on its side. And there we go. Okay, now I've done a liner, and we talked about the measurement. I'll tell you again, it's 4 by 7.5. We're using the Black Cat 12 by 12, and then this is actually from the pattern. So far that's the only pattern, 12 by 12 pattern that I've introduced on this page. And that's supposed to go down another half inch. There it goes. Okay, so that goes in like that. Now the top is an inch and a quarter, and then the bottom is also an inch and a quarter, and it happened to be a little piece of scrap that I had. Inch and a quarter, inch and a quarter. This is going to be the pocket liner for on this side. Go, and then this is going to be the pocket paper. I'm using mahogany powder puff. to ink all my edges. Oops. I dropped, or my glue tipped over. Okay, now on this, I have, like I said, I trimmed down this ephemera card so that it's narrower, and it's going to be placed right here. And I just basically want it centered up and down, left to right. That looks about right. Get out my Tim Holtz ruler. Just make sure I get it in straight. Actually, I have it a little over to the side, and that's good because we're going to put something in this pocket. Now, here is our card that's going to go in the pocket. I'm going to reintroduce this stripe here. So it's going to be what's sticking out of the pocket. Again, from the 12 by 12 collection pack. And then this was a piece of scrap I had left. So we are going to add this to complete the card. There we go. Now I'm going to do a little something here. I'm not sure what at the moment, but the next thing we're going to do is fill in all of this. So as you can see, there's tons of room for photos. Okay, so that's all the A sides. I'll be back shortly with the B sides. Hey everyone. Okay, I picked up some papers for the B side, and so we're going to start with these two. This is from the Patterns and Solids, and this is from the 12 by 12 collection pack. Hope everybody's doing well. Did you guys see the new Graphic 45 collections come out? We're pre-ordering right now for the Christmas collections. They're always wildly popular. And they're available to look at online at www.scrapandcreate.com. And one is a new collection introduction. The other is DCE, which is a re-release of a previous collection. So yeah, Warm Wishes is the new one. And then 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, I think is what they call it. Or the Night Before Christmas. Yeah, I can't remember. And then we're going to reintroduce this. I trimmed it off here, here, and then I'm going to add green on the other side, which I will trim to fit so it's not cut yet. And just to give you an estimate, this is, it doesn't have to be precise, it looks like it's 1 7/8. So if you're trimming it yourself, just make it 2 inches, whatever works for you. This happened to just be a sliver off that one. And now we will trim to fit for the rest of the panel. It always fits one way better than the other. There we go. Because I'm actually cutting it at a slight angle because this went in at a slight angle. That's why I mark the top and bottom. Because what I really want is a uniform gap and mat around the cardstock. So even if it's in crooked, you won't be able to tell. It will mask it. Okay, looks good. A little heavy-handed on the glue there. Now we're going to do the same thing on the second half. We're going to use the same patterns. So I'll close that up. And we'll open this side up. We're going to do essentially the same thing. So we'll start with on the outside. I've got some ink on here. Again, I forget where I put the second stripe. Second stripe goes over here. I said stripe, but I meant strip. This should fit right here, and it does, but I have not inked it. Now we're going to trim this to fit. Hmm. That's very crooked against here, but it's very straight against here. So I'm sure I'm going to have to cut that one at an angle. Let's see. How we did. I need to get something under here to see the edge. That's pretty good. Need to ink it. There we go. Okay, so the last thing is these two panels. And I don't know what I want to do yet. Do I want to cut into that? Hang on, I need to find something else. Ooh, how about this? Maybe this. Kind of like the purple. That's kind of fun too, but that's a lot. It's kind of hard to see how to put a photo on that. Do we have much of the green cat? You know, we have enough of the green cat left from previous. Let's do that. Pulls that back in from the front here. I'm gonna measure that real quick. I think it's four, and yep, four. There we go. I like it. See, I've got some ink here, but it comes right up. That's one of the reasons I really like this ink, is it's not messy. I can get it off me, I can get it off my mat. That's it, we got it. We could do both. Let's do both. I don't usually do that. I'm a symmetry person, but feeling bold. Here we go. I don't think I've ever used my border page uncut. I usually slice them out. So there we go. Lovely, lovely. That is page two. Oh, no, it's not. I'm going to do something here. I haven't figured it out yet. I'll be right back. Okay, I found this cute little girl here. So this is one of the ephemera cards. And then I extended it. So it's basically the same length as this card. And I'm going to put it at the same level visually. It's going to go right here. So it's going to overlay this pocket slightly. Now, I've got magnets sticking to everything. Once we get this down, this will be the end. A page two. Isn't that cute? Looks like it needs to go for just a little tab. And then this will be centered right there. So the other thing I did while I was away is I didn't measure this right because I didn't want two things to show out of the pocket. So I went away and I trimmed about a quarter inch off the bottom and then I just inked it. I didn't try to make a tab extender like this. And now when you tuck it in, all you see is a green. You don't see a green and a little strip of that orange. So in the cut list, well, there's two things. I still think that the, what was it originally, 7.5? Yeah, 7.5 is the right size, but this needs to be bigger than 1.25. It needs to be 1.5, the decorator paper, decorative paper, 1.5 on each end. So I'll give you the cut list for 7.5, and you'll have to remember to do a 1.5-inch drop with your designer paper so that you don't have your little other piece peeking out, which is not the end of the world. I just like it better this way. And that's the way I was originally planning it. So there you go. And then I'll repeat this page. And when I do, it'll be the 7.5-inch. And then this, I want to come down just a little. I might even put a piece of, just a dot of glue on either side so that when you put this card in, it stays centered. But I hadn't decided. By not putting glue, you can add a larger insert if you want. So that's it. That's the end of page two.